Hello students, in this lecture of chemical kinetics we shall study about some basic concepts of chemical kinetics. What is chemical kinetics? It is the study of about the rate of a chemical reaction. What is the rate of chemical reaction? We will see by considering this general chemical equation, that is AA plus BB CC here, A number of moles of A reactant. These are reactants of the chemical equation and these are the products. By this chemical equation, we come to know that A moles of reactant A and B moles of reactant B, they are combining together to form the product. And what is the composition of product? That is C moles of C, product C, and D moles of product D are formed by this chemical reaction. Now, let us see what is rate of reaction. In this chemical equation. See, in this chemical reaction, the reactants are being used in the chemical reaction and they are producing the products. So, the concentration of reactants are decreasing. So, the rate of decreasing the concentration of reactants, that is delta A with respect to time delta t, this is the rate of reaction and this is multiplied by the stoichiometric reciprocal of stoichiometric coefficient of the reactant in chemical equation. And as the concentration of the reactant A is decreasing, we put a minus sign here. This is the rate of reaction and this is equal to minus 1 by B with respect to concentration of reactant B. Again, we have put a minus sign here because the concentration of reactant B is decreasing, also decreasing. This is the rate of reaction and the concentration of products are increasing as the chemical reaction is progressing. So, it will be equal to 1 by C delta C by delta T and this will be equal to 1 by D delta D by delta T, rate of change of product D with respect to time and multiply by the reciprocal of the stoichiometric coefficient. See, we have not put negative sign in case of products because the concentration of products are increasing in the chemical reaction. Now, this rate of reaction can be represented by another expression, that is rate of reaction is equal to or directly proportional to concentration of A to the power x and concentration of B to the power y. This is another way of representing rate of reaction, because rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactants. And if we put an expression which describes the relation between rate of reaction and concentration of reactants, that is called rate law expression. This is rate law expression, and this is equal to K See, here K is the constant of proportionality. It is called rate constant. This is called rate constant. And see, X and Y, they are determined experimentally. There is no theoretical expression, there is no theoretical equation by which we can determine x or y. They are determined by doing the practical, by doing the experiments. And by there, we see that how this rate of reaction is related with the concentration of reactants A and B, and to the sum power of the concentration of reactants. Here the power of concentration of reactant A is x, and the power of concentration of reactant B is y. So x and y, they have no relation with the stoichiometric coefficients. They don't have any relation, but they are determined by experiments. They are determined experimentally. So this is the rate law expression. This is called rate law expression. So, what is the rate law expression? Rate law expression is that describe the relation between rate of reaction and the concentration of reactants. Here, K is the rate constant, and we can say that if K is higher, value of K is high, then rate of reaction will be high. Rate of reaction will be fast. And if K is low, this is less, then rate of reaction will be less. This is constant of proportionality. And this is rate law expression. And now we see that in this equation, rate law expression, let us write it on the fresh page. R is equal to K A X B Y for the reaction, for the reaction AA plus BB CC plus DD. This is the general equation, the general chemical equation. And here this is the rate expression, rate law expression. This we have studied. Now, in this case, x and y are determined experimentally. And x plus y, that is called order of reaction. This is called order of reaction. If x plus y is equal to 0, the reaction is zero order reaction. If x plus y is equal to 1, it is the first order reaction. If x plus y is equal to 2, it is the second order reaction. Let us take one example. This order of reaction can be 0 also. It can be negative also. It can be fractional also. Because experimentally, if we find that this x is equal to half or 1 by 4 or one any fraction, then the order of reaction will be in fraction. By taking one example, let us see that if we have a chemical reaction 2NO plus O2, that gives 2NO2. Here rate is equal to KNO2O2. Here x is where x value of x is 2, and here it is 1. If nothing is written, it means it is 1. Then it is third order, because 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Then it is third order. Its order of reaction is, order of reaction is 3. How can we determine these 2 and 1, how they are determined? They are determined experimentally. That at time, how the experiments, t is equal to, at t is equal to 0, if there is some concentration, and at time t is equal to t, what is the concentration? What is the rate of decreasing of concentration? And that rate of decreasing concentration may be fractional also, and they are determined experimentally. So, this is the way this order of reaction is determined. Now, in our next class, next lecture, we shall be studying about molecularity of a reaction. Molecularity of a reaction and how it is different from the order of reaction. This topic will be taken up in my next class. Thank you. Here, one thing you have to take care, if the order of reaction is 0, means the power of both the reactants, power of concentration of both the reactants is 0, then we say that rate of reaction is independent of the concentration of the reactants. So this is the importance of zero order reaction. Means it is independent of the concentration of the. See, if we have like this, rate is equal to K A 0 B 0. This is zero order reaction. And by the zero order reaction, we say that this R, rate of reaction, is independent of the concentration of A and B. Whatever be the concentration of A and B, the rate of reaction will remain same. And it will depend only on the constant of proportionality, K, rate constant. Now, one more thing. What is the unit of rate of reaction? Unit is, rate of reaction is mole per liter per second. If the time is given in second, or mole per liter per minute, whatever be the case. And what is the, this K is the rate constant. Higher the value of K, higher will be the reaction, rate of reaction.